Nobody does authoritarianism quite like China. By 2020, every citizen will have a social credit score that will go up and down based on their personal behaviour. Behaviour leading to a deduction in credit will include jaywalking. Bad driving, smoking on trains.
Dear passengers, people who travel without tickets or behave disorderly or smoking in public areas will be punished according to regulations, and the behavior will be recorded in the individual credit information system. To avoid any negative record of personal credit, please follow the relevant regulations.
Buying too many video games. Buying too much junk food. Buying too much alcohol. Calling a friend who has a low credit score. Merely having a friend online who has a low credit score. Posting fake news online. Criticizing the government. Visiting unauthorized websites. Walking a dog without a leash. Letting your dog bark too much. At least in 1984, Winston Smith could take a train to temporarily escape the surveillance state that he labored under. In China, low-ranked citizens will be prevented from taking buses, planes, and trains.
我现在是已经被限制这个自由的出行了，就是订票啊，我们高铁和飞机都不行。我跟你演示一下，我们用这个APP来订票。现在是我们从重庆到西安，我们来订一张票，订一张过几天的票。
And what does it say?
然后就显示那个出票失败，说我已经被法院依法限制高消费，限制乘坐G字头列车。
Now where have I seen that before?
That's reserved for members of our Prime Flight program. You got to be a 4.2 or over to qualify.
Oh, I'm a 4.2.
I'm afraid you're actually a 4.183.
Well, that's not my fault. Some woman dinged me down in the cab drive. Can't you just...
I'm sorry, it won't let me book it without the correct ranking.
6.7 million Chinese people have already been prevented from buying air and train tickets, and the system hasn't even been properly rolled out yet. The punishments for citizens whose credit score sinks too low are limited only by the imagination. Renting a house, getting a loan, booking a hotel, filling up a car with petrol, all will be restricted.
I can't buy property. My child can't go to private school, he says. You feel like you're being controlled by the list all the time.
Good behavior will also be rewarded by green channel benefits, free perks, discounted loans, fast-tracked visa university and job applications, VIP airport access, faster internet speeds. Dating websites are even offering users with high credit scores better visibility on Tinder-style apps. The loyal informant will be well taken care of. And the entire system will be overseen by an estimated 400 million surveillance cameras with facial recognition software.
Cameras record them going through intersections, zero in on their face, and then publicly shame them on nearby video screens.
And it will eventually encompass real-time geolocation tracking of citizens via their cell phone. Overall credit scores can go up and down in real time based on a person's behavior. But it can also be affected by the people they associate with.
Two stars?
Wasn't a meaningful encounter.
Everyone is a little bit heightened and false because everyone's terrified of being marked down because the consequences of that are unpleasant. So it's basically the world we live in.
And all this will eventually be unified in a centralized database. In the words of the Chinese government, if trust is broken in one place, restrictions are imposed everywhere. They literally say that those deemed untrustworthy will be, quote, unable to move even a single step.
一个人如果信用不好，我们实现的一个目标就是让守信者通行天下，让失信者寸步难行。
When you ask Chinese people about social credit, most of them say it's great. Gee, I wonder why.
I think it's a good thing, this woman said. It makes people more honest.
我倒觉得挺好的。Could it be because under that very same social credit system, they will be punished for criticizing the social credit system. But social credit isn't just about behaving yourself, it's about marshalling the behavior of others, the prisoners guarding the other prisoners. The Chinese government just doubled the reward for reporting the illegal publishing of pornography. "I'm not going to work today," wrote one potential porn buster on Weibo. "I'll look everywhere for materials so I can report anyone who I find disagreeable. There's money to be made in reporting, so what am I doing working myself to death?" China already has a spy program to rival the East German Stasi. In one area of Beijing alone, Chaoyang, there are around 120,000 paid informants in operation. Once social credit kicks into high gear, so many more thought criminals will be detected that all those Uyghur Muslims in Chinese re-education camps are going to have a lot more company. The Uyghur minority is already forced to download an app that reports their entire browsing history and real-time location to authorities. Now that same system will be extended to all Chinese citizens. But who cares about what's happening in China, right? I mean, it's not like they're selling the same technology to be used in the West, is it? Think that a social credit score could never happen over here? Well, think again, because it already is. Thanks to Silicon Valley, people are already losing their public square platforms for voicing dissenting opinions. People's trustworthiness is already being ranked by social media giants depending on what links they post. People are already being refused bank accounts, e-commerce, and the ability to raise money for expressing controversial ideas.
Isn't Silicon Valley basically doing this anyway? They've started to kick people off. If people have the wrong political views here in the United States of all places, they can get kicked off payment processors. Nope, you can't do e-commerce. Nope, we're not going to host your website. Nope, you can't have social media. No, you can't use our email service. No, you can't have a blog. It doesn't even have to be on-site behavior. No, you can't have a Twitter because you said something we don't like on YouTube. No, you can't have a Google account because you're too edgy. Your Facebook posts prove it. Is that not the same fucking shit? And the amount of power, the amount of centrality, by the way, in Silicon Valley is more than that of China.
Now Democratic 2020 candidate Andrew Yang wants a social credit-style system introduced in America. Just imagine going to buy groceries with your credit card, and then because someone in an office somewhere in San Francisco deemed something you posted on the internet to be hateful, your transaction is declined. I mean, forget even trying to pay. Your implantable microchip will be blocked, so you won't even be able to enter the shop. That's our collective future. Entire organizations funded by government are devoted to identifying and destroying people's careers for the crime of wrongthink. People are being disowned by their own family members and ostracized from society merely for being conservatives. I mean, why blame China? All they're doing is formalizing and systemizing what's already in existence in the West through mob outrage culture and public shaming. We're already living under social credit score light. And while the Western media lambasts China for their social credit score, they simultaneously cheerlead and lobby for an almost identical system in their own backyard. No, it's not just wrong when they do it. It's wrong when it happens here, and whether it's giant corporations or government orchestrating it all, it makes no difference.